Hey, this is Jason Howell, JD. Today we're gonna talk about how to fix your construction in your flips. All right, now this is video 17 of 365 videos, my journey from flipper to private equity fund manager. Now, the question, how do you fix, you know, construction, and why is that even an issue, right? So you bought this place, and now you have to bring value to the place and do some repairs to it in order to bring it on the market. Now, this is where things can get kind of chaotic, right? Because there's no kind of rules. And you know, you can get, you know, beside yourself and put too much money in it, and therefore now that the investment is, you know, no longer an investment, you're just trying to recoup your money. Because your construction costs ate up your profit, right? This is a very important aspect of this business. You know, and you need an organized strategy of how to do this, right? So the best story I can give you is this. You know, I had just kind of sold a house, and I had this nest egg, and I was gonna start getting into, you know, flipping houses. And I was gonna do my first big, flip, full-fledged renovation. It was a 3-bedroom, 2-bath that I was changing into a 4-bedroom, 4-bath, 2-story, in an area in Orlando called Colonial Town, right? Across the street from a botanical garden, right? This is a fabulous house, really nice bones, and I was gonna make it into $1 million. It's a really ambitious plan. But I didn't know the first thing about construction, right? So I talked to my mother, I said, listen, who do you know that can help, help us on this project? And she's like, she knows this guy from Jamaica that he can build furniture from like wood from scratch. I was like, all right, let's go give him a try. So we start, working with the guy, and I start seeing cracks, in his plan. He would go from one thing in the house to the next without actually finishing it. And then he just kind of stopped showing up. Finally, he just kind of finishes it. Right? And, here I am. This deal turned into a money pit. I have everyone here trying to figure out how I'm going to turn this thing around, because I'm going to lose my shirt on this deal. Right? And I'm here figuring, I'm really starting to fret. But I said, one of the arguments I had with this guy was he wanted to get paid for some kind of partial work that he done. I said, how can I control that from not happening with another contractor? So I said, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put together a scope of work where we're gonna go from room to room, right? And we're gonna put on that room, this is the work that needs to be done, and this is the labor that needs to be done. And I want you to give me a quote for the labor, and I'm gonna know the cost of the material, because I'm just gonna cost it, right? And this is how I actually was able to salvage that deal, right? Because now, if I had to fire him midstream, the scope of work is page for page, it's room for room. So if there's an argument, I can say, listen, you didn't do this, 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 but you did that. You said, this is what I'm gonna pay you for, right? From then on, I did that on every house, right? If you do not plan, you plan to fail, right? This is a very important topic here, right? So, if you want to make sure that you actually stay profitable, put together a scope of work, put on one side the actual material and the actual, labor, right? Room for room. And now you can really, control your costs under construction. Now, tomorrow, we're gonna go over another topic, how to create rapport, right, and trust with your clients, right? To your success, blessings, one love.